Lord,
reached where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, and we shall be inspired by the Word of God.
Of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas carried on from Perga till they reached Antioch in Pisidia. Here they went to synagogue on the Sabbath and took their seats. When the meeting broke up, many Jews and devout converts joined Paul and Barnabas. And in their talks with them, Paul and Barnabas urged them to remain faithful to the grace of God that had given to them. The next Sabbath, almost the whole town assembled to hear the word of God. When they saw the crowds, the Jews, prompted by jealousy, used blasphemies and contradicted everything Paul said. Then Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly. "We had to proclaim the word of God to you first, but since you have rejected it, since you do not think yourself worthy of eternal life, we must turn to the pagans, for this is what the Lord commanded us to do when he said, 'I have made you a light for the nations, so that my salvation may reach the end of the earth.' It made the pagans very happy to hear this, and they thanked the Lord for his message. All who were destined for eternal life became believers. Thus the word of the Lord spread through the whole countryside. But the Jews worked upon some of the devout women of the upper classes and the leading men of the city and persuaded them to turn against Paul and Barnabas and expelled them from their territory. So they shook the dust from their feet in defiance and went off to Iconium. But the disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, "We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him, singing for joy." Response:
"We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock." Response:
"We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Indeed, how good is the Lord. Eternal is merciful love. He is faithful from age to age." Response:
"We are his people, the sheep of his flock."
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. I, John, saw a huge number, impossible to count, of people from every nation, race, tribe, and language. They were standing in front of the throne and in front of the Lamb, dressed in white robes and holding palms in their hands. One of the elders said to me, "These are the people who have been through the great persecution, and because they have washed their robes white again in the blood of the Lamb, they now stand in front of God's throne and serve him day and night in his sanctuary. And the one who sits in the throne will spread the sun, their scorching beam, will ever break them. Because the Lamb, who is at the throne, will be their shepherd, and will lead them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away all tears from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please all stand for gospel acclamation.
Steal from the Father. The Father and I are one. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The sheep that belong to me listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I don't get to say this very often, but for once, I think I know exactly what Jesus is talking about. My family come from the hill country of Donegal in the north of Ireland, good sheep farming country. And my great uncle William was a good shepherd. Every day, up until the day he died at the age of 92, the first thing he had to do every morning was to go and check on the sheep, to make sure they were all right, to make sure they'd got through the night. And so, every morning he used to get up very early, long before dawn, and walk the 3 miles up the mountain. And sometimes I would go with him. And when he got to the place, he would sit down on the dark hillside and wait for the dawn. And as the light came up, he would see his sheep shining out of the darkness, one by one, like stars coming out of light. At the time, it seemed to me strange that he never counted them. His sheep had names, not numbers. And as each one came into view, and he recognized it, even at a distance of 300-400 yards, he would call it, very softly, by its name. And when he had seen them all, and seen that they were all well, nothing bad had happened to them during the night, and they were all feeding well, then he was content. Then he was able to go back down the mountain and have his own breakfast. We asked him why he did this. None of the other shepherds did. He told us that our people had been shepherds as far back as there were records. That his own grandfather had lived through the famine. In the famine, it was the sheep that saved us. And so he knew that so long as his sheep were all right, the family would never starve. And so that meant that every day the first thing he had to do was to know that his sheep were all right and that nothing bad had happened to them during the night. And he couldn't eat himself until he was sure of this. He could not bear to think that he would be sitting at home when one of his sheep was in trouble on the mountain. I think that is exactly what Jesus means when he speaks of himself as the Good Shepherd. And I've always liked to think of Jesus like that, watching out over his sheep, making sure that all of them are doing well, keeping all of them in view, and calling each one of them by name. My family still has sheep on those hills. I rather like to hope we always will. And I also rather like to hope that in my own life as a priest and doctor, I've tried to live out a little bit of the tradition of faithful shepherding that my great uncle William left to me. And I also rather like to hope that in every generation, the Holy Spirit will raise up faithful shepherds for every flock of his people, wherever it is found. And maybe rather pushing my luck, but I also rather like to hope that there may even be someone here to whom the Lord is calling to the faithful service of the people of God in the church. That is not a call for many, but it is a call for all of us to reflect on the sacred responsibilities we hold in life. The sacred responsibilities we have been given in trust to the next generation. Maybe there are people here, young people who do not yet know what it feels like to be given a truly sacred responsibility. You do not yet know what it is to be given something so precious that you must not drop, whatever the circumstances and whatever the cost. How it feels when everything is going horribly wrong and trusting eyes turn to you. If there are people here who have not yet felt that, don't worry, it will be alone, and sooner than you may think. Let's pray today, each of us, for our own sacred responsibilities, and how the Lord may prepare us to fulfill them faithfully, to all those sacred responsibilities that she puts in our charge. And let's stand and profess our faith in God, who shepherds each and every one of us. We stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, and through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he was buried and was resurrected, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures, as he ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in
glory to us, the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And now let us put all our own prayers and needs before God our Father and Jesus the Good Shepherd.
For our Holy Father Francis and our bishops, that they may be good leaders in the Lord's flock and filled with the Holy Spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For leadership to restore peace in the world and an end to innocent human suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For young members of our families and communities, that they may follow the Lord's call through lives of generosity in care for creation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For those who are studying for the priesthood and religious life, that they may be strengthened in their vocation of loving service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For all who are sick in hospitals, nursing homes, or being cared for at home, that they may have healing and comfort. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For all who have died, that the Good Shepherd may lead them safely home to the kingdom where every tear is wiped away. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us ask the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and our death.
And we've been asked in this Mass to pray for the repose of the soul of Michelle Burns, her first anniversary, and the repose of the soul of Robert Ryan. And we've also been asked to pray for the first death anniversary of Sofronio Farinas, for the soul of Venancio Castro and Consuelo Farinas. Eternal rest grant unto them all, and may perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace.
Amen.
Compassionate God, you lead us through darkness to your wonderful light. Hear our prayers which we make with faith in the name of your Son, the Lamb who gave himself for others. We make these and all our prayers through the same Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Oh,
God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, and with one voice we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Together with Francis Alcott, Prince the Bishop, the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Pray with me. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am worthy that you should enter under my roof, but not to say the word, my soul shall be healed.
And the body and blood of Christ brings all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
You are the one.
Let us pray. Kind shepherd, look on your flock. Be pleased to settle in those fresh pastures, these sheep you have redeemed. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated just for a moment. I haven't been given any notices. I don't know if anyone else has. I'm not seeing any indication of any notices. In that case, I just want to say thank you all very much for inviting me back to celebrate with you. It's been wonderful to be with you today. Especially on such a beautiful day. I hope you all have very nice things planned for this afternoon. And I hope you all have a very beautiful day. Thank you very much indeed. To those who are celebrating the Lord's Supper, I wish to say, Maile Maile.
Thank you, Father.
Please stand and raise your faces to receive God's blessing. Lord God, we give you thanks for the sacred responsibilities you have given us to serve. We ask that you may be given the strength. We may continue to serve them throughout our lives. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Are you Christians? Let us go. Proclaim the gospel.
Thanks be to God.